Introduction about myself, I don't think I would waste our time getting introduced. That I'll keep it at the end of it, which will make more sense to me. I would like to have your introduction, your name and your profession. If you can have a flying round, it'll be nice. Starting with
my
you.
My name is Rajesh. I visit the health lab regularly and I'm working in an NGO.
Nice. Yes, sir.
My name is Kannan. I am a general manager in food corporation.
Wow. Yes, sir.
My name is Shahid. I'm working in food corporation.
Welcome, sir. That's nice. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
My name is Lai. I'm retired.
Thank you, sir. Yes, sir.
Hi, my name is Arun Chalwani. I'm a engineer.
Oh.
I'm Raj. I'm an electronic engineer. I take interest in various topics.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Fine. Thank you, all of you. In brief, I'm Dr. Derrick Angelsz and would be introducing you to graphology, a form of healing. Now friends, I would like to know, are you aware what graphology is or any idea or have you heard about it? That's the first thing, yeah.
Looking at the handwriting and the signature of the person,
right,
you can come across his psychological and all those strengths and weaknesses.
Okay.
What is he good in, what is he not good in?
Fine. Anything else? Any knowledge? Very roughly, briefly, or whatever.
On the handwriting, brief attitude and the patterns of human being can be judged.
Okay. Right.
That's what I heard.
Right. Yes, sir? Okay. Fine. Let's have a little bit of clarity before we go to the number one thing. I don't like to use very big terms. I like to keep it very simple. Now, graphology is the second stage of handwriting analysis. Like, if you want to be a graphologist, first you need to be a handwriting analyst. In handwriting analysis, what we basically do is we look at the pattern. In our language, we call it graph. No qualified graphologist will call it a handwriting. He or she will call it only a graph because it is a line which is running up, down, and all over the page. Now, looking at that and having your basic studies or whatever studies you've done, you are actually only reading the graph. And after reading the graph, what the person is doing is interpreting. He's like an interpreter. It's like he's looking at your formation. He's saying, okay, this, X, Y, Z, whatever. He tells you about your personality. He tells you about your health and various other things, your professions, etc. Now, once the person is through with that part, being a good expert into that, then he moves over to the higher level of so-called graphology. Now, when we say graphology, then a lot of science gets included in that. A lot of science. Where basically, according to whatever places I've been, I've traveled, meeting people, meeting more and more graphologists across the world, it is seen that the science of graphology is to its minimum. Means it is not highlighted. Most of the places we find that a person goes to a so-called graphologist, enrolls in a workshop, learns handwriting analysis, calls himself a graphologist, gives you some corrections, and that is done. That is what we are doing. Healing part, the corrections. Now, my dear friends, is it possible that you turn into a surgeon just by listening to a doctor? Definitely not. You definitely need all your experiences first. And then later on, you gradually get into being a graphologist first. Now, healing comes, I'll tell you, much at a very, very high stage of graphology, whereby currently in our European society, we are still working on giving this science a different terminology. Because what has happened is, like, it has come to an end. The graphology, reading, analysis, using it in forensic sciences, etc., interpretations. It has come to a circle where it has come to an end. The circle is completed. Now, the new dimensions which has been added to it as the science part, currently we have added the astrophysics, the geoscience, and so many biochemistry, etc., into so-called graphology. So we at our group, we feel it is unjustified to study so much all these years and give the credit only to graphology, whereby the graphologists have no idea about what's happening. Let me give you a small background of graphology again. The father of graphology, I'll just read out his name. Camillo Baldi, he was from Italy, and this was in the 16th century, sir. Somewhere in the 16th century. Now, according to the books, according to whatever we have the information about the written part, we have something starting from the 16th century going up to the 18th century, the 19th century, and to the current time. Now, in all these things, whenever we have read, most of the time, what was involved was a psychologist. Most of the time, it was a psychologist, and as sir said, it is understanding the behavioral pattern of a person. So that what happens, okay, that is good in your analysis, in your corporates, in your companies, and in other various places wherever it is needed, even in your police stations and in the court of law, etc. By the way, in the court of law, this is not a permissible evidence, let me tell you this. Nowhere. Whether it is India or it's Portugal or it's Greece or it's UK for that matter, let's say that's the biggest hub for graphology out there, yet it is not permissible. But everybody would admit one thing, that it helps 99.99%. In the sense, suppose you have four probable convicts, you don't know who's the culprit, who's the main culprit, and you give their formation, a graphologist will sit, analyze, he will say this is the guy, you probe further, you will get it, and yes, you get it 99.99%. That depends on the graphologist, of course. Now here we are talking about form of healing. So may I rub the board, is it okay? Now let us understand that just by writing something, how can I heal myself? Simple. It actually sounds stupid initially. How can I just change my signature and change my destiny, or change my alphabet, so-called alphabets, and improve my health? Simple, my dear friends. I'm just simplifying the whole science. When I'm using a pen, what am I doing? I'm moving my index finger, largely, unknowingly, subconsciously, I'm moving my index finger. Now, the index finger is connected centrally to your whole body system. Along with that, it is one of the main connectors of your blood flow system. Now, what happens? Every time you move, the flow of your blood changes in your physical body. The flow changes in the physical body. Now, when the flow changes in the physical body, your energy body, or the astral body, what we call it, the outer part, your energy body, it also has some kind of differences happening in the energy. Simple example, can we see the light? Can we see the fan? It is moving fine. Now, my question is, can you see electricity? You have coatings, you have wires, you've got everything fine. Even that wire is not electricity. It is not electricity. There's an energy.
Way out.
Sorry?
Way out.
Yeah, there's a way. It's a flow. We can't see it. Physically, we can't see it. Same way, we have a body, we have an energy field, which is present, but we cannot definitely not see it. So as the earth is moving on its own axis, having the energy, the outer pull of the solar system, having the pull of the moon, the sun, and the other bodies which are around, it is not only the earth which, you know, takes the toll or understands the differences, but also our body. Simple, the high tide and the low tide. Why? Because it is water. What is there in our body? Water again. Fluids. So even our fluids are changing. The fluids are changing at the same time. So when I'm holding a pen to write something, depending how the graphs are going, could I have a better pen, please? Pen, a darker one? Yeah. But can you see the board? We'll change the pen, but can you see the board, all of you? Yeah. Fine, what I've done is basically, I have deliberately changed the slant to speak in simple language. I've deliberately changed. Here I've kept it almost like straightish, not straight. Here it's more slant, and here it is like another kind of slant. It's like, you know, the slants are running haywire all over. Now what happens is, when I'm moving my finger for this kind of slant, my index finger is moving in a different direction. For a straight slant, again it's moving in a different direction. Again for a right slant, thank you ma'am, again for a right slant, it's yet moving in yet another format. Now, could I have a volunteer, please? Sir, please? Yes. Now, what happens? We are talking about healing. Now, if I have to look at my formation, I'll do it in blue. These are my lines which have come straight, slant, different angles. Correct? Then different angles. Now, if I have to place my body, if I have to place my physical body as per the slant, that means if I have to talk to him, if I'm talking to him like this, what happens? He says, okay, fine, this guy is quite friendly. If I'm upright and straight, he will say, no, this guy is like, he means business. He will not come too close. He will just have a handshake from far away. And if I'm talking to him like this, what is happening? He's saying, this guy is not interested. Now understand, I have changed my body position deliberately. Okay, if I'm having this kind of slant, you do this, just do. Where is the pressure coming?
In the back.
Exactly.
Lower.
At the lower back. If I'm like this at all times, the pressure is coming on my lower back. So when my finger is moving, it is actually creating a pressure on my lower back with that kind of slant. Besides that, the gravity is working otherwise on my body. When I'm straight, the gravity is working on me, but because I'm straight, the gravity is quite okay. I can take the gravity. I can do this very easily because the area of gravity is minimum. If I'm doing this, the area of gravity, all this comes in the area of gravity, which means if I have to do this again, I'm getting heavy pressure on my back. I may even break my lower back. So this is the simple science about your slants, how your slant goes. Depending on the slant, it represents, thank you sir, thank you so much. Depending on the slant, it represents your body. Okay, if I'm too much like this, it means I may tip and fall. Yeah, depending how slant it is like. So what do? If somebody is there, I might take help. Okay, fine. I need help. Somebody's help. So these are the kind of people we say who like to take help, support at all times. They cannot do things alone. I need help all the time. So looking at the slant, you understand what is happening with the person. Now, as I said earlier, that just by listening to something, we don't turn into surgeons, right? But today, since you've come here, I have to give you something at least, that you can go back home and have a good life at least, something. So we have something in the market called Anacin, Crocin, Iodex, Vix, whereby anybody takes and applies and goes to sleep and feels better in the morning. So I will give you all this Vix, Iodex, Crocin, Anacin today. Other major parts, I will only speak about it but not give it to you. Reason being, it needs a huge balancing factor which can possibly damage you, which I don't want it. Now, why is it so that I can give you only Anacin and Crocin? Reason, every handwriting, we call it, is not a handwriting but a brain print. No two zebras in the whole universe will have the same stripe. They're all different. Men also. No fingerprint ever in the universe will ever match.
The modern forensic sciences say fingerprint is not the be all and end all of everything.
Okay.
So there is something about that also.
Okay. So we stick to zebras. So what I mean to say is the brain print. Now the brain print cannot match for anything in the world. Take my word, it cannot match. I can defy. Meaning, if somebody says, okay, I can copy the signature, I say, do it. Copy the signature, no problem. Trust me, you will do ditto, same to same. You will copy your slant, blunt, everything, dot, fort, everything will come perfect. My question is, can you copy the energy?
Pressure on that thing.
Pressure is fine, sir. There is something called energy field again in that slant. Like how I said, there's an energy field which you can't see. Same way, you have an energy field in your handwriting. Now, I have taken it that you have copied. You're the best copy master. You have Xeroxed it. Another copy. But you cannot copy the energy. And this is where the best of the best graphologist walks in, not just a graphologist. Even a graphologist can make a mistake. If he does not know to read the energy of that particular handwriting, sorry to say, he is not in that elite group where he or she should be. And that is the reason we say, you know, this is a science which should not be tempered with. You know what happens? I've noted this. I'll give you a small case. One guy comes to me, one of the patient, and I do graphology for him. I give him corrections, everything, etc. Done, fine, good. He's very happy. Third day, I get a call. Sir, I'm feeling fit, fine. All my things are done. I've got my visa to US, and then I went to London. Everything, blah, blah, blah. Next month, he comes back to me crying, saying, I need your help desperately. I said, okay, what happened? My father is serious. I said, okay, take me to him. Saying, no, he's in the hospital. I was like very cool and casual. Nothing crossed my mind at that point of time. I said, okay, what happened? Then he was telling this happened, that happened. And I don't know why, something crossed my mind suddenly. I said, Victor, his name was Victor. I said, Victor, I remember you saying that you are a lazy person. That's what he had mentioned. That I'm lazy, I don't do work. Give me something that I become active. I said, okay. And I gave him according to his formation for something to be active. What this fellow did, that formation, he gave it to his father who was around 70 year old. In that, what happened, when his father practiced the same thing what I gave to Victor, his blood pressure went high and he got a heart stroke in 3 to 4 days. It is dangerous, my dear friends. That's why when I have a client, I always tell them, my dear friend, this is for you only. It is not that I'm scared that you will spread it around. I'm not scared of that. I'm scared that that person might take a hit somewhere. So when it is doctor's prescription, don't share that medicine with your friends or your family members. Those medicines are very dangerous. Those surgeries are very, very, very dangerous. Okay, now let me give you the first one. Okay, any of you suffering from blood pressure problem here? Okay, so what's your high?
Mild.
Mild. High pressure. Okay, anyone else? Low pressure. Okay, fine. Now this is something I'll tell you. I'll take the board ahead, so maybe you can see better. No, don't worry, sir. That's fine. Yeah, this is okay. Fine. Veena, it's fine with you? Right. Now, I'll show you. This will take like few seconds, right? Then I'll tell you the science and the history behind it, how it developed, how it came into being. You take a pencil. Now, there are certain things which works only with a pencil. I'll explain it why. And there are certain things which works only with a ballpoint pen. That also I'll tell you why it works like that. Fine. Now, suppose this is your blank page. You take a pencil, you make a circle. And then I come out and I make spirals around it. And I go on making spirals without thinking. I'm not thinking anything. I'm not saying blood pressure low, blood pressure low, blood pressure low, blood pressure high. I'm not doing anything. Casually I'm playing with it. Only playing with it. Whether I'm doing it this way or moving my whole arm, I don't care what I'm doing. But I'm moving it. Now if you notice, I was very careful in the beginning when I made the circle. If you see, the first circle which I made is very clean. We call it clean. If it is like okay, but the inner part is very clean. I didn't put a single dot inside. I was very careful. And I did not lift my pen thereafter. I completed it and then I came out and then I started making my spirals. And if you notice, I never went back inside the circle. I did not go back in the circle. I kept the circle clean. Now, if I have to do this on a piece of paper, I will go on doing it as much as I feel like doing. I will do it for 1 minute, 10 minutes, 15 minutes. I may make 10 circles, 20 circles, or maybe 1 circle, or maybe 10 pages, no problem. Because in graphology, the higher end of graphology, there is no such thing as time. Time is null, it is zero. Because we have linked this science with astrophysics, space outside Earth, there's no time. If I tell you, let's assume, if I tell you right now, okay sir, okay ma'am, you do this 3 times a day and you fill 3 pages a day, you know what will be running in your head? 3 pages and 3 times a day. I didn't tell you anything. I just told you, take a piece of paper, only make sure you're having a pencil, make sure your circle is good, you come out and you go on making spirals as much as you want. I don't care about it. You stop when you want to stop. You make one more circle if you want, you make 100 circles, or you don't make the second one also. I am okay with it because it is helping you. Very simple, right? Pencil. Your Natraj pencil, I mean just a wood pencil, right? Yeah. Yes. I was waiting for that. Thank you. This is anti-clock. Anti-clock, ulta. This direction. This is anti-clock direction. Now this is one of your innocents which is safe. Safe. You show it to your friends also, not a problem. Not a problem, because this is pretty harmless. It will not harm you. As long as, see there are some captions there. As long as you don't come back in the circle. Point number one, please remember this. One, the circle has to be clean. Second, spirals you can overlap, not a problem. But don't come back inside the circle. If you want to end, you end it anywhere you want. But don't come inside the circle. Done? Fine. Third point. When you finish doing this, you tear that page, tear it and throw it in the dustbin. This is very important.
In a plain paper.
Plain paper. If it's lined, if it's ruled, it's okay. It's okay. Possibly a plain paper would do good. Good for you. So why? Why have I told you, you make a circle, you don't come inside the circle, stay outside the circle, end wherever you want, and at the end of everything, Baba, please tear it and throw it in the dustbin. I didn't tell you throw it in the loo and flush it, and I did not tell you to burn it also. Scientific reasons. Scientific reasons. Now, what happens? First question, how does it work? And why does it work? And so safely that anybody can use this. Now let's see the benefits of this. Your pressure, whether it is high pressure or it is low pressure, it will eventually come into a balancing state. Even if you are a normal person without having a pressure issue, yet you can do it, because this is a great balancer of your blood pressure. So anybody can do it. There's no time factor, ma'am. Anytime. Anytime. Number two. Sure. Number two, if you're undergoing stress, you got stress, do it. It's a great stress releaser. I'll tell you, this was this is used. I don't know, I've been like visited more than 400-500 schools where I've given this. Students, we have actually seen the difference, who were very naughty, you know, very wild. So what I suggested, the management and the principal, 2 minutes before the recess, make them do this and tell them tear it, throw it in the dustbin and go out for the recess. Eventually, within 2-3 months, I get the report that the students are pretty normal, non-violent and well-behaved. They play and all, but they don't fight, they don't push, they didn't do all that musty and shouting and yelling. All that is calm down, because all the energy is divided and balanced. So when you're under stress, it's a great thing to do away with your stress, because again, stress affects your blood system and your other organs get affected, etc., 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 whatever. So this is again a good way of taking care of your stress. Next, if you have a headache, no problem, it'll get you back.
Migraine,
yes, very much. Next, if you have any heart issues, basically heart issue is like what? When there is a blockage, or if your wall becomes big or it becomes narrow, again there's a difference in your breathing pattern and your blood flow pattern. Because when it becomes big and there is more blood gushing in, again the blood is also split, so that also becomes a problem. That also normalizes this. So this is a very safe thing to use. Now the question, how does such a simple thing, some people say, I should do it in college, I should do it in school, lekin kabhi kaam nahi kiya, or you never realize it, maybe, right? But you did not use a pencil, number one, and you didn't know that you have to come, you should not come back inside this. Now, why I'm not coming back in this is because this is my space, my safe zone. I'm making my safe energy zone, I'm making a energy zone safe, and I'm coming out of it and then I'm moving around it. Now when I'm moving around it, I said use a pencil, because pencil is made of wood, number one, and the inner part is either lead or graphite. Lead or graphite. Yeah. So when I'm holding the pencil, the gravity of lead and graphite is very high. It has a great pulling power. So what happens is, my cellular cells of the body, they are highly intelligent. The brain is stupid. We never give any consideration to the brain. The brain is damn stupid. It doesn't know to think in the first place. That's why we have all this problem. So when I'm holding it and when I start moving it, the cellular cell, every cellular cell of my body or anybody's body who's doing it, starts realizing that it has a chance of releasing the unwanted energies and the imbalances of the body. Reason, there is a graphite or a lead which is having heavy gravitational pull, which will be pulling me out. And because the index finger is involved, representing the whole body, it starts giving it out at a great speed. So, and next, I'm not doing it on a wall, I'm doing it on paper. Paper is again natural, made out of wood. So when I'm moving, I'm giving out all that is not required by my physical body, not because of my brains which is telling me to do it, but because of my cellular cells, the intelligence of the cellular cells, which are releasing all the elements out of my physical body. And there you are having an equal, balanced physical state of well-being.
What is the requirement of circle? Why can't it be any other form?
Yes, sir. If it is any other form, then the issue changes altogether and completely. It changes altogether and completely. For example, when I have a person who has high mental stress and it is like an emergency. Now this, please don't do it, because this is only if required, we need to check the balancing. And if that it is like an emergency, then I will not give this as the first one. I may give him very roughly something like this and this, or maybe this and this. It depends on the requirement of the person. In terms of, like, you know, high mental stress, suppose a person like wants to commit suicide, this process at that point will be a slow process for that person. I need like instant, fast. So I prefer this, something like this. Now in this, the direction is very important. The direction of my last line is very important. So understanding the person's need, I'll give the direction. Understanding the problem of the person, I'll give the direction of the last line. Very important. If I fail to give a wrong line, I will damage him more than what he's damaged at that point of time. This is safe. Now you understood how your elements and your energies are coming on the paper. Number one. Fine, done. Now I told you, tear the paper and throw it in the dustbin. Why? Because when you tear it, the energies remain as it is on the paper and it goes in the garbage and it is out. If I flush it, some people say, why don't I flush it? If I flush it, it goes into the element, into the water element. Again, not good. Because again, it has the vaporizing issues. And my body's cellular cells' intelligence are also present. Whenever it's passing by in the form of vaporization, I can possibly catch it again. I'm telling you, it's very high energy. For example, it's 10,000 voltage. If I'm standing here, I'll go and stick to it because of the high voltage here. Same way our energy works. It'll stick once again. Next, if I burn it, very bad. I'll catch it instantly. So all that I do is down the drain, as good as not doing it. So might as well tear it nicely, throw it in the dustbin, and of course it goes to the garbage. And
what is the logic of circular motion? I can understand if you hold the pencil and the blade is there. Now that pulling what you call force and all this. When I move it,
so the logic, yeah.
Is the connection of movement?
Yes, it is a connection of movement. As I told you here, I cannot give you, I can't tell you, okay, just leave it down. See, I told you this is the whole representative. So when my body is moving, my finger is moving here. So when my finger is moving, I'm understanding how much of rotation it is taking. Now if you just keep your finger and do a rotation, it actually is like a cone. The top is broad and the bottom is narrow. So when I'm having this circular motion, the maximum point is here, right? So this is pulling and spreading it outward. So if I'm doing this, so it is tensed up all the time. It's going in a tensed motion constantly.
You mean energy is flowing in a vortex form?
Yes, that's right, sir. So your movements, your directions are also very important. So this is one NSN I can give you, which is really, really good, one of the best. Now,
there are some people who shine and do this kind of form below their
signature. Yeah. I'll come to that, sir. Now, yes, ma'am? It's up to you. See, on one paper you can do any number of times.
First one size sit and I do one paper, I throw it. Second time I sit for the day, I do it.
Yeah. Every time you do it, you tear it and you throw. Don't throw it, and tear it and throw it, please.
Is it advisable to try and move on the same circle?
See, it is not.
It has no meaning.
It has no meaning.
Only it should not come inside.
Exactly. It only.
The movement has to go on widening.
Exactly, sir. Exactly. Because what happens, only the first time you're like careful, the first one. And once I come out, I can just do it. Because I told you, this is stupid. The brain organ is stupid, not working. The cellular cell is highly intelligent. I'll give a simple example. Karate, Kung Fu, whatever, martial arts, Jackie Chan, Bruce Lee. Do you think they think and block or think and attack? No. It comes naturally. Whatever movement comes, you just hit him and he'll go and block you. Reason. All the cellular cells of the physical body, the hand and the leg, they are so programmed. The mind has no time to think. It just goes and blocks or it just goes and attack. Okay, I'll give you another one. Some of us write so fast. Sorry, think so fast you feel you're writing slow. You start skipping alphabet sometimes. Some people, you know, they want to write fast. Actually, they're thinking very fast. The thought is very fast. The physical body is very slow to the mind speed. Some of them. Same way it works. Once the cellular cell picks up the intelligence of any activity, it has picked it up. Okay, forget that also. How many of you drive car here? Okay. Now, by now maybe it must be 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, whatever, you must be driving. Do you sit in the car and think, nahi, my car be switch, I have to put it on. Then I have to, oh, this is a clutch, this is a brake. Then I have to do this. No, you just sit down, you start and you're talking on the phone or you're talking to your friend and you're looking here and then you're driving properly. Are you using your brain? We are not using our brain. This is your cellular cell intelligence. Yeah, of course, depends on the situation. I'm just in a simple example, on example format. So now, if I have to actually look at it, I can just take a pencil, turn it, do it for some time, and my job is done. Maybe I finish off the whole thing in few seconds or few minutes. Can you just take a guess to get to this point of research? How long this must have taken? To research this. How long it must have taken? It took me more than 3.5 years to come to the dot conclusion point. Yes, it works. And to get here also, there was a reason for this kind of research. Since we have so much of interaction with scientists and research scientists and all these people, you know, this guy says like, we work under conditions where we've got everything. Everything. We've got the games to play, we've got to do this, we've got to do that, everything done. But the stress is not coming down. Obviously, how much video games can I play? How much of music can I listen? And how much of videos can I see or whatever it is? There will come a point where I will be saturated. Because I'm using my visuals, I'm using my brains. So that also gets tired. So we needed something to de-stress and, you know, go over and go ahead with quality work. That was the feeder for the research work, and 3.5 years and job done. And after this research, of course, there were many, many things which opened up for us at a gushing speed, I would say. At a gushing speed. So my dear friends, this is a safe thing which you can use. All okay with this? Any questions here?
I have a question.
Sure, sir.
Not exactly on this.
Fine. Sure.
Now I can understand one way when you write it because of the brain pattern.
Right.
Or your attitude, personality, and all this thing, your handwriting comes.
Right.
Then you have that handwriting analysis.
Yeah, whatever they do. Yeah, right.
Whatever.
Correct.
Based on the experience, you have that.
Right.
Pattern.
Right.
Now, this I can understand.
Fine.
And you can judge the personality.
Correct.
But the reverse way,
yeah,
which in many advertisements I have seen, change your handwriting, change your life, and
yeah,
all this thing.
Right.
Now, I can understand even if you change and you change your energy pattern and
right,
your thinking remains same. Because major stress comes based on your thinking pattern.
Right.
So, if your thinking remains same, how you can change?
Yeah, fine. I'll give you an answer for this, sir. Let me tell you one thing. As a friend, I would say, whenever you're going to a graphologist for any kind of your work, please make sure of his or her background. Reason, I'll tell you. Because there are many of them, like, you know, suppose Mr. A has learned graphology, next day he opens up a shop. I'm a graphologist, without knowing anything. So that can damage the client. So, coming to sir's point, okay, one moment, so I'll just get back to your answer. Are we done with this?
Yeah.
Okay, should I rub this?
So this is just to de-stress?
Yes, not only de-stress, sir, but all your body compositions.
To come down, balance.
To come down and balance it.
High and low, both are...
Yes, high and low, both, sir. Even if you're like having no blood pressure problem, yet you can do it. Absolute safe.
So it's a balancer?
Yes, it's a balancer, right.
Balancer.
It works for a very long time, sir. It's like when you're normal, you just do it once a week also, it's fine for you, because the multiplication of energy field in our physical body and our outer body is equal to 6,000 times, which means if I'm writing my name Derrick one time, in reality I'm not writing one time, I'm writing 6,000 times. It is that almighty powerful. And current research which is going on, we are trying to multiply it to 60,000 times using metals, getting into, like, you know, changing the metal and trying to see if we can multiply the factor by 10,000 times more, so that becomes like 60,000 plus.
So what are its benefits, sir? 6,000 times or 60,000 times, what are its benefits?
See, sir, the benefit is we are just doing, speeding up things. Like, suppose, as I said, if a person is into depression, I have to go to that mode. Using this metal, you do the same circle, it'll give you the same result quicker. And there are certain times where you need an emergency. So, this will not be given openly, like, you know, just okay, fine, this is available and you do it. It's, of course, it's under complete care that we give it.
Does it help you use a pencil regularly compared to a pen? Or?
Yes, of course. Now, I'll tell you the reason why pen should also be used. Okay, another thing, thank you, sir, for this, because I just remembered something out of that. Why you should use a pencil? I told you it's lead, it's graphite, whatever. Now, what happens is, if I use a pen, for the same thing, the effect will be zero. Now imagine, you will say, okay, you said you can turn, your finger is turning, everything is happening. Yes, everything is happening, but there is no gravitational pull. Because the ink contains plasto, man-made, artificial, no pulling power, no gravity, zero. It doesn't work. Only your energy will be like going up and down, up and down, up and down. That's it. It will not come out. It will stay static where it is. So there's a reason for this kind, what I showed is a pencil. Now, next. How many of you have memory problem? Like, I don't remember. I forget.
Sometimes.
Sometimes. Okay. I'm one of those who have deliberately disconnected my memory. Being a graphologist, like, you can do anything. And since we have to experiment and do researches, we are like guinea pigs for ourselves, because we can't experiment on human beings. So there are times where, like, I'm sick for 3 months and 4 months and I'm doing nothing. It really takes a toll, big toll on your health. So then after all my work, I came to a conclusion, I disconnect my memory, and I disconnected my memory completely, which means nothing affects now. Anything happens now, okay, fine, done, finish. I'm just an observer. Like, I go and sit and watch a movie, let anything happen in the movie. I enjoy the movie and I'm out. So, coming to memory, again, this is a safe one which you can use it for yourself as well as for your children, especially in school. If they have to, like, you know, when they go for exams, some of the children, they say, oh, I studied everything and it's not coming. Come fast. It's not coming. Actually, the student has studied. It's an overlap, unable to bring it up. Let's see what's the problem. Now, again, this works with a pencil. Same thing, paper, white, plain paper, using the pencil, same finder, same format. Now, how does this work? Let's see what I'm giving you on board. Have you been to any of the beach around?
Waves,
that's right. I'm giving you waves. All you have to do is do nothing but make waves. Simple waves. I'm not being an artist or nothing. Simple waves. But even these waves are having some catches in it. Catch number one, it starts from top. Catch number two, it ends on top. Again, it is not ending down. Catch number three, they are all smooth, they are not rough. You don't see any rough edge here. There's no rough edge. They're all smooth. Now let's get to the science part of it. Why and how does it work for your memory? It's very simple. This portion, okay, I'll put it here. You see this portion? This part, the down part of it. This is called the retainer. It retains. Retaining holds. Because like a cup. It's like a cup. So if you put something in the cup, it retains, it holds. You turn the cup, everything is out. So this is the retention, and this top part is the expulsion. It gives out. This top part. This goes in, this goes out. So what happens when I start doing this? Very simple. When I do this and I study, my retention cavity is created. The hollows are created for retention. And at the same time, the capacity to recall is also created. Meaning, I have given a question and I've given you answer also. I've given you both. So you need not worry what to do. No, I've given you both solution right bang on. I've given you the question and I've given you the answer. Anytime you want, alright. Because I have the answer. Next, this flow is a smooth flow. There are no breaks in this. Which means it has a good continuity and holding power. When it has a good continuity and holding power, what happens is your memory remains good. You grasp it faster and you store it faster and you recall it faster. And I started with top because I want to retain. Retention, no? I have to retain it. Very important. So, this is a very simple way of retaining, recalling and grasping whatever you do. Whether you're a lawyer, you're a businessman, you're a cop, or you're a student, you're a housewife, anybody, or just a speaker. This is okay. You tear it or you keep it, there's no problem because the energy is fine. We are just working. No, please don't rub it. You use a fresh page. That would be nice, using a fresh page. And for this, I would strongly recommend not to use ruled paper. Use a plain paper.
pencil.
Yeah, with pencil, of course. Please use a plain paper.
Why not rule paper? It will give some guidance.
No, rule paper will not give entangles. What happens is, when I do it on a rule paper, my visuals are 70%. So my brain starts acting against it. My brain looks at that rule paper as hindrances. So it goes and clashes with what I'm doing. Though I'm not thinking about it, but actually 70% of my visuals are working even if I'm not thinking about it. That is why the moment you close your visuals, you're actually a better person. Most of the time. Like when we have... Yeah. That's fine. It's up and down, whatever. Only thing is, need to be smooth. That's it. That's why I said there is, it's not sharp, it is like smooth.
And the ups and downs have to come one below the other? Or
anyhow, that's not a problem.
Advisable in the
other. Yeah, advisable. See, if you notice something, every time I tell you something, I don't make it rigid. You know, when I put you in a rigid position, then it becomes a problem. Yeah, then you're cautious, you're thinking what to do, aisa karo, waisa karo. Only the points which are important, I'm just saying, like for example, chalo, I have to remember to start from top, nothing else. Even if I take big waves, chalega. If I make
free flow,
if I make small waves, no problem. But I'm not rigid on those parts. But where it is important, I'm just giving you the points out there. But please feel free to ask me any questions. Thank you so much, sir. Yeah, you can do on the back side of the paper. Yeah. As much as you want, sir. Whatever I'm telling you, it's free. You do it one time, 10 times, 1,000 times, it's your call. There's no time limit. There's no number limit, there's no time limit. Yes, that's right. Right. Grasping. Understanding the things faster. Faster than what usually one would take time. Now see, I removed a piece of paper and I read out and I said thank you. Because I mentioned I've disconnected my memory. For me, so many things are not important because I can store it on a piece of paper or on my laptop or whatever, XYZ. So I don't bother it. I don't bother my brains. I must remember. It's not important for me. It's like that. By the way, I just made some notes so that, you know, I don't miss certain points with you guys. Okay. Now these two things are done. Now we come to the alphabets. Oh, sorry, I can rub it off?
Yeah, yes.
Thank you.
Only one thing I wanted to ask.
Sure.
Is this connected with your biorhythm or something?
No, it is not connected with the biorhythm. It is connected with the cellular cells, whereby now this pattern is connected to your brain cell. This is connected to your brain cell, and that is the reason when it ends on the top, it ends here on the top, here. Because the storage is here, of your rote memory.
Sometimes I heard just a very simple explanation of graphology, that whatever you write, your mind's energy or whatever comes on the paper. That's how.
That is analysis, sir.
Analysis.
That is analysis. That's a different science. It is. I'll tell you, it is so vast that I'm telling you, a lot of information is not available even on the net. Let me be very honest on this. Not available. Like, I'm writing a book. I thought I'll finish, I'll publish it, and I'll give it out. Then I realized so much of information is coming in. My research works are still going on. So I've just delayed it. Because when it comes out, it'll be good for everybody to understand that graphology is a science almost superior to your nuclear science. It is, for example, you say Brahmastra, very powerful. It is that powerful. Now, testimonies, right now I don't have with me, but there are people who can just stand and talk to you. Oh, this happened. Like, I got a call yesterday, one girl calls me up, say, sir, thank you very much. What happened? I got promotion. How much? 22,000 rupees. Okay, I'll tell you about this girl. I met 1.5 months ago. I saw a signature. Change your signature, gave her the signature, fine, done. She was earning 4,000 rupees. 1.5 months today, she is like promoted 2-3 times, earning 22,000 rupees. Yesterday, I get the call. It's just a small thing to share with you. It is not only promotions, it could be anything in your field. Anything. All right, we were coming to alphabets. Alphabet D. because this is one of the most two important ones. I'll do the D first. Okay, why don't somebody come and write a D? Or maybe one by one, two, three of you can write D. Just write D, yeah. Okay, now write the small D. Okay, fine, thank you. Anyone, please? Yes, ma'am, please come. We can have 5-6 formations, we can explain it. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you. Wow. Oh, that's fine, that's fine. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. So take this. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for coming up here. Now, you take a look, whatever you can see from your distance. All are different, which means all your physical bodies at this point of time, they are running differently. They're all running differently. Now, I'm sure you must be remembering your D. I don't want to pinpoint, I'll just look at the D and tell you what it is and what should be done safely. I'll come to this one D, yeah, this one first. Now, if I look at this D, I actually get a little worried. I get a little worried when I look at this D. Two reasons. One, I see, first I'll just tell you what I see, and then I'll scientifically make you, please come. Then I will scientifically explain why I'm talking what I'm speaking. So let us just flow through it first. When I look at this D, I'm actually getting a little scared. Somewhere my mind tells me, okay, TK, things can be balanced and taken care of. Why? This person is physically stressed, pretty highly stressed, not very highly, because I'm not looking at the other formations. I can safely say pretty highly stressed. Or at least the physical part of the torso region is highly stressed. I'm talking about the torso region now. It's highly stressed. Now this person also is not so fond of eating. And this person needs activity, does not like to sit and watch TV or like, you know, do nothing at all times. Likes to move. Now in the bargain, what has happened when I look at the capital D of it again, it is giving me two loops on top and bottom, which means the mind is also like spinning, running too much. Yes. If, and secondly, looking at the strand of the small D again, thankfully, this is one thankful part of this D, that it is sort of medium. So, I understand somewhat the blood pressure is almost okay. But, if continued, can shoot up. In the bargain, the blood will start rushing at a great speed. The brain region is unable to handle the circulation of the blood. And there is a mismatch between the circulation from this region to the heart region. So two possibilities are here. Either the heart can collapse or the brain can take a hit. Possibly, thankfully, the brain can take a hit. So the heart is sort of quite safe. So what we need to do, okay, explanation done, fine, let's go to the next one. Let's take this. It's like I can take a breather, safe, nice, good, but this day. This person has given me a lot of loop here, in this region. And here he has cut the loop inside, which means because of his emotional issues, his physical body is taking a hit. His physical body is malfunctioning, not functioning properly because of the emotional issues the person is going through. And the emotional issues which are going on are unwanted majorly. Meaning, if you have a problem, you're my friend or known person, my life is going on, what happened? Acha, so and so thing happened. He is crying, I'll also start crying with him. Unwanted emotional issues, which is not required, definitely not required, because it is hitting the physical part of the body. Now, physical part means boom. But the good point again is, again, when I look at the capital D, it is clean. It's like blessed. You're blessed. I'm thankful that you've got a clean D here. So your vehicle is moving nice. Chalo.